Worship as we ask our Heavenly Father to be in our midst and in our presence. Dear and loving God, we ask you as we sit here this afternoon to take forward the work of the Old Georgian Association, to be a mindful presence, to be a guiding force and a light in all the work that we deliberate upon this afternoon. We ask you very specially to bless all our Georgians here this afternoon and all those who have worked tirelessly to make this event this year a grand success. As a school community, O Lord, we are grateful for the work of the Old Georgian Association, for their loving kindness and support in all that we do as a school and in all that we do to take it forward as we strive for excellence. All this, O Lord, we ask in your most holy and majestic name. Amen.
Patience, prosperity,
Shivakashi with the past principal Mr. Hammack, and Mr. N. R. Krishnamurthy Raja was the charter president, and G. Ashokan was the charter secretary, and that's how it has grown to this levels. And with the support of the internet and the website Yahoo groups, thanks to Tuski, who has been rendering a big service since the last 10 years, and that's how people have been able to, you know, get in touch from all around the world. And today we see a large numbers is all because of the website, which has been very helpful for Tuski to do all this. And again, I have to thank John Kaspers to find our founder John Breeden. It was really a Herculean task. I really appreciate his efforts and all that. So today here, it's going to be the third time I'm standing in front of you in this dais. As I became the president in 2012, it's been 2 years, and I think after all this, the secretary report and the president report is over, we will have an election to be conducted, and we need this to carry on till 2014, when we have the next 100th year. There will be some new generations to see us. Thank you, and this is just a starting, and I'll just go to the next point now. Who's here? Can I get a proposal? Yes. Tom, Vinu Varki, and Partha. So the quorum is here. I'm going to the next listening. Agenda changes. and or approval, anything? As on date, there's nothing, so we go to the next one. Consideration of the minutes, the annual general meeting held in July 14, 2013, the last year. It's all there. I request you all to go through the complete minutes, what happened last year in the AGM. And please do ask if you have any specific queries, any time in the day or in the evening, we'll be ready to tell you on that. The next on the agenda comes my dear secretary, Guruji Baba, Praveen Pujara's report for what he has done in the last 1 year. Here to Baba.
Any mistakes, please don't laugh. I would like to thank the board of the school, the principal and patron of OGA for the cooperation that they have extended over the last several months in the run-up of the century. My greatest appreciation for the efforts taken by Tabla Vishu, Tiski, Jeku, Nimi, Sheila and all the other OGAs who have played a very important part for the success of the century. I'd like to specially thank all the outstanding OGAs who have so generously contributed a big amount for the infrastructure of the school and having attended the century in such good strength. I'd like to thank all OGAs who have traveled from far and near. Remark your attendance in the century this year. Without you all, I'm 100% sure a century celebration will not be a great success. We have had all the regular meetings in the last 2 years, some at the school and some at the OGA then, which was very strongly attended by many OGAs. Thank you.
Again comes to be the President's annual address. And here once again, Georgians, it has been a great pleasure to have been a president of this August and a great association, the Old Georgians Association. It was started in 89 and I finished my schooling in 10th in 84. Believe me, when I left the school, I thought never in my life I'd come back here. I think the present students also should be thinking with that. Those were the days like that. But in 93, when I heard that there was a reunion going on and some classmates of mine had come, like Thomas Verke, Sunita Chacko and all that. So we all rushed and we were there for 2 days. And since then, for the last 21 years, I have been attending all the reunions in KT Valley. And I have been also attending all the off-site reunions, which has been happening every year for the last 10 years since Baywatch in 2004. It was only in 2012 when the off-site reunion in Kodaikanal started and I couldn't make it because I had gone to New Zealand. Today I really see a good crowd, and being the 100th year of the Laidlaw Memorial and 25 years of OGA, I appreciate people who have come from all long distance, like Donald Peacock and Henry Marion, from all the way from, you know, Australia, coming just to this reunion and just getting back memories of what they all enjoyed during the days, heydays of their times. It has been a very special privilege to be chosen as the president of the OG, especially because my presidential term would be right in the middle of the run-up to the centenary of the school and the silver anniversary of the OG. It has been a challenge to put together effective teams consisting of live-wire old Georgians who would have to be charged with bringing up many projects to fruition. I must also add here that old Georgians have stepped up to the plate wherever necessary and have made things happen. Our association has grown from strength to strength during the last 2 years. Members of the association have increased substantially. I thank the principal and patron for that, because every year when the students leave on the plus two, majority of them, I think it's 100% of them, become a life member of the Old Georgians. So there is a percentage of increase every year, thanks to the management and policy, and I hope it's been happening every year.
Electronic and internet-based interactions between members of the association spread across 34 countries has been tremendous. 34 countries is very damn good. I have personally been the beneficiary of the largesse of OGs in many countries. And in the last 2 years, I had been to Australia in Wollongong in 2013 March. It was really a very, very good time, and we had a fun-loving time. The six of us has been there. It was me, JP, Raja, and other three guys who are all stay nights. The moment we landed in Melbourne, we were picked up by John Kasperus, and the next 10 days, every place where we went, in Melbourne we were taken care, then we went to Inverloch for 3 days, we were taken care, then we landed in Sydney and Noel French was there, Max French was there. In fact, Noel was playing his hockey for the, you know, above 60, so he also came and gave company. Then at last we went to Brisbane and we had Mr. Rama Reddy coming in a big jeep, and he really kidnapped us, and you know, he took good care of us in Gold Coast. Then the next day, then Madhuradi arranged a huge dinner with all his friends there in Brisbane. Really, it was very fun loving. We all miss them a lot, and really seeing them over here today is a great pleasure to be a part of this August OG Association. OGs overall have come forward in large numbers to help some OGs who are in need for help, for healthcare, and even those who need financial help for the education. A lot of this kind of help is done with no public announcement or fanfare, or so many are unaware of this intervention by OGs. So it has been all happening internally. If somebody needs, example, we had a society member in the name of Abhishek Raj. So he wrote to us stating that his son and daughter had studied here, and his son is in a very bad state. He's like a wedge, he's not able to move. So the OGS, you know, discussed and we gave a good amount to them. The centenary year brought us along special challenges that did not have to be incurred by my predecessors. The plan to install a bust of the founder principal of the school, Reverend Breeden, was one of the challenges, and thanks to Tusky, the LCC chairman, he has taken the hard efforts. Then we had to find the sculptor. They have found him in Chennai. Then the mold was made, and the mold was being inspected by Sheila, and they gave a green signal, and really it has come out well. And the first day when we came here for some expo meeting, in a distance, when I saw the bust of Reverend Breeden, I thought by mistake they had made Tamil Arasu over there. Only thing is, Mush is a little thick. I think there is some gene DNA, you know, interlocked between Reverend Breeden and Tamil, because the passion what he has towards the school and towards the OGA, the energy is always outflowing. And to tell you a few more words is that my son, who has studied here from 4th to 12th, has passed out in ISC 93% and got 95% in commerce, and he had a cakewalk into Loyola thanks to Tamil Arasu. Because how much he does here, I feel, is only 10%. 90% is there in Loyola. It's a huge campus, and Tamil Arasu is known, and being the vice president of the alumni, he is known well and well. May God bless him for many more such good things, good deeds. Anyhow, so today we had the bust opening. So it has been a great challenge for the OGS to find out Mr. Breeden's photo, take a bust and all that. And really coincided, you know, for the 100th year. I have to thank Tusky, who has been really behind it to get all the details, going to the Ramsey Church in Egmore, finding it out, then, you know, speaking to John Kasperus, getting more details. Then, you know, so much details. If you all read the coffee table book, you will know the details, you know, since 1921, how things went on. And then who wrote the school song, then we had to find out that. But really, you know, the being the web being available, a lot of things has been interacting, and people who are in the Yago group will know that there are so many things happening, and everybody's birthday is there, so a lot of people are wishing you from all around the world, and there's prayers for you. There was then the centenary coffee table book project, which was taken up. And I have to thank Nimi Itticharia, who has really, I think, in the last 2 months, she wouldn't have slept. She would have worked 24/7. She never thought of anything other than this coffee table book. I request you all again today to just give a standing ovation to the lovely work she has done with the support of our patron Michael James.
just come on stage, please? At the back of the book, and we've had a lot of stuff in our archives, but it wasn't in any organized form. We had an amazing file of old stuff, which included a lot of newspaper cuttings and things like that. So, to the best way possible, we've tried to put it together. And when I took this up, it was a kind of a, I'd say it was a recklessly adventurous moment, because I fully understood that I was merely a nutritionist, not a historian or a writer by any stretch of imagination. But I think a lot of OGs have helped me pull it off, and it's been an amazing journey, like I said, from the time Tusky made that phone call to me, to the time we took off about 1,000 kilos off the train in Coimbatore station on Monday of the book. And just to tell you, I hope it's something that will help you understand the heritage of your school a little better, and I hope it's a book with soul. So I'd also like to thank Shailendra Bhaskar, my boss on the project, who was my sounding board and my punching bag. Also, my sister Vatsa was not here, who did the same for me. Anyway, I really hope that it'll be something good. The only job I've been thrown out of is a copy editor's job. So if there are any copy edit mistakes, you've got to forgive them. Okay? So thanks again, and I hope you enjoy the book. And I've had an amazing time with Michael getting the book together and the photographers. There were instances when Ashwin and I, we roasted spuds behind dining hall when Ashwin had to catch a train in another 3 hours from Coimbatore. So we put kerosene into it, and you'll see a photograph of that. We had to make the fire glow, and there were a lot of amazing moments like that. And most of all, I hope you'll be proud to be Indian or of Indian origin when you look at the book, because it's been printed at India's best facility, Prakriti Offset in Hyderabad. So thanks again. And all this adulation is actually due to the people who helped me on the project. Thanks so much.
Profitable book. And the second project what we took was the centenary walkway, which you would have been all seeing it today, Georgians, and the present students are all seeing it. We just thought that we should make a walkway like the last time, but again we wanted to find out budget and the resource for that. So in a year before, we had decided that we will make a tile. So we had some suggestions from a lot of Georgians on the net. And the idea was actually to put the tiles on the pathway, but that did not turn up. So then we thought that we will put it onto the side, and we fixed up a price of 3,000 per tile. And we are going to have the opening of that. And presently we have close to 300 tiles. And still we have a space for another 200 more. I request all present and the past Georgians that this 3,000 rupees is just today a marginal amount. Please pay up and take up this time, and this name will be in the school for generations to come. So please make a note, and we are going to have a separate stall for this booking on the 13th Sunday during the carnival fete. The people who have just seen it, please pay up 3,000 rupees and get your tile name to be fixed during your, it will be installed in batches, right from 1927 till 2014 is there. Have a look at it, and I request all women that you should all be a part of that. I should thank the contractor whom we took up, Arnold Whitley, that the project really went on time, because suddenly there was all rains coming and all that. In between, the school was closed for a month, there was elections and all that, but really he took all the pain to see that maximum tiles would have been put up, and you know, the paint has been done well, the plastering has been done well, the site, the names, the commemorative names, everything has come up very well. So he's not here, but my thanks to him. And we thought of this walkway. We had got a design from an old Georgian in Delhi based. It was fantastic. You know, there's a lot of space for people to sit down and do all that. But the budget was close to 27, 28 lakhs. Then we had to again go back to Mr. Sanil Sivadas, our past president, who had done the other way walkway. And we also thought on that budget also was hitting close to around 17, 18 lakhs. Then only we had thought that let us go for little something within our budget between 8 to 10 lakhs. And this way we got this contractor, and we got all the stuff from Coimbatore at a very subsidized rate. And that's how the whole total budget had closed up to around 8.5 to 10 lakhs. But earlier we wanted to keep the width as 10 feet. Then Tamilar sir said let's have it at 12 feet, because all the 600 students will be walking down and up. So now it has really come out well, and the lights and all it has come out with the British style and the paso light. So it's come out very well. We'll be all able to see that this evening. So that was the second project which we had taken up, and it really went well. The third project was the commemorative stamp. The centenary postage stamp featuring the school centenary has also been brought to fruition thanks to the efforts of the new OGs. You will actually be able to carry home a few of those postage stamps, as they will be available for sale at the memorabilia in the fete carnival on Sunday. The centenary reunion has brought together hundreds of Georgians from every continent on earth, and I am especially proud of the team of the OGs that planned and put in place the celebration of 100 years of the school. I thank you all from the bottom of my heart for partaking and taking so much of your time and spending here to be on the campus for this once in a lifetime, the 100th year celebrations. I would like to specially thank the chairman of the board, the vice chairman, and all the board members for the unceasing support and ensuring the success of the centenary reunion and the 25th anniversary of the OGA. Because every XCOM and NCC meeting we used to call them, if they are available in town, they did make it up, and they did give all their valid suggestions, and that's how all the things have come to place today. And believe me or not, in the last 2 months, Tamil has never made me sleep. Every day I get 25 calls, you know, just to see whether things are going up right or wrong, or you know, pushing metal on top and all that, and then again to skip. So that's how things have been happening, and today we are really satisfied on what has come out, and we'll just see how far it has to go again. As my team, I demand office at the end of this AGM. I would like to thank my entire team who's sitting over here, including Baba, my secretary, and Guruji, who has been a great, you know, a support. Because the last 2 years, we had close to around 8 to 10 meetings of XCOM and LCC meetings. The LCC meeting used to be here. The XCOM meeting, he said that it should be at his house in Konam. And he also named it as OG in Delhi. Believe me, we had crowds of around 60 people in the night, and his cook, a fantastic cook, he has really made me put on weight. He used to give fabulous food, and we used to have music and all that till 1 o'clock in the night. So I really thank him for his extended support he has given at all times. Whenever I call him Baba, I
I need a work to be done. He says, yes, Jay, I'm always available for OCA. Anytime I used to go, the moment I go to his house, immediately he'll pour me a drink. Then only he starts, you know, discussing and all that. So we really went a great way, and it has been a good team setup and all that. And I'll be missing this all in the future as a president, but as a friend, he's always my role. I take him as my role model. I also have the entire team behind my vice president, who's no more, but he's also been of a great help, always calling up and finding out what is next, what has to be done, what should he do from his side and all that. Then the treasurer from Tirupur, always very cooperative, asking any help, any signatures, anything. And believe me, the t-shirts today, we got it all. You'll be all wearing that tomorrow. It has been all done from his end. He has done a fabulous job. And I think after wearing it, then you should all give him a big thanks for doing that excellent job over there. And other than that, Debbie was available for all our meetings. All our ISKCOM, she was here and she was really of a great help. Then other than that, I would also appreciate my complete committee members who have been here in large numbers during all the ISKCOM. And I take pride in this situation to give them a small memento for the help they have been rendered as an appreciation for the support they had given me. I would now ask Uday Kumar, Tirupur. Divya Nilakandan, Divya, great help being in local, giving us a lot of helps and inputs in the last 2 years, moreover the last 1 year for the LCC also. From morning 6 a.m. to night 10 a.m, his calls are always, I know well, he has my number, Jayko, 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 and he really made me run around here, but still on this stage I thank him for giving me an opportunity to grow in OGA, and it has also made me grow in my business that I've been working more now these days. Thank you. The next man, the computer wizard, software wizard, Mr. Sailendra Bhaskar Tuski, who has been of a great, great help by coming in the last 2 years, giving a lot of support in all my areas. Where I had doubts, I just have to give him a small call and he gives me a big lecture about what has to be done. Then I would like to call upon Mr. N.R. Krishnamurthy Raja, the man responsible for the OGA since 1989, to be the charter president. And it has been the 25th year celebration, and hats off to him for his start 25 years before he had the vision that there should be an association and alumni and old students. It has been happening earlier, but it did not perform well. But he had to get Mr. Hammack, and they did not have a chance to start it here. So they had it in Sivakasi, and slowly, so during Mr. Gardner's time, they started to go on, and today we have grown into a big banyan tree, and we have been a part and parcel of the school. Thank you. Suresh Namakkal, sorry, he is not here. The founder, treasurer, N.C. Nilakandan, a man from the local KT Valley, who has been responsible from the beginning for treasurer for a long time. And they have made a big, the OGA pitch, on which he was really a man inside and out. And today also, any work you call him in KT, is always there to help any of Georgians out. Thank you. Then it's Ashokan, who was the founder secretary in 1989, but he is unable to come today because of some health conditions. But I would like to give a big word that he has been always helpful, and every year he is sponsoring all the crackers worth around 30,000 to 50,000. And this year he is ready to, he has, I think, for this afternoon and for the mega night, he has sponsored close to 2 lakh rupees for the fireworks. So let's all give him a big hand. And I request Mr. Kamal Arsul to come and take it on his behalf and pass on the love and affection the OGA has on him. Again, my another coordinator, Trevor Green, please come in the front. Whenever we had some doubts and meetings, he used to come to Coimbatore to my office and give me some good support. Thanks, Trevor. With this, I'd like to end my speech. It's been too long. Now, as you all know that I'm stepping down, I wish the incoming team all the best and promise that my team and I will be always available to help with any future OG's projects in any way we can. One of the signature features of the OG has been the phenomenal continued support that the past presidents and executive committee members have offered to the OGA. This must continue forever. As you all know that I also in 93 when I came, the crowd was not even so much. We used to have numbers less than 10. So we used to come see our friends, have food, run away. When they say AGM, no, it's just like calling a student to the classroom. We used to all run away. But just in the last 20 years, there has been a huge change. And we'll see in future more people getting committed to the AGM. In the same way, when I got, as I told you in 84 when I left, that I will not come back to the school. Then I came back in 93 and every year I used to be coming. When I got married in 95, I bought my wife here in 96-97. She thought that I would like my children to be in boarding and she told me that never in her lifetime she will leave her children into boarding. But the reason today is different. In 2005, Rahul Prithvi was put in 4th standard here. And 2009, my daughter Neha Jaikumar was put into Laidlaw. So this is what she has felt. And now she is a very happy parent, seeing that the son has got 93% in ISC. And he has done very good from what he was the most naughtiest boy over here. He has really transformed in the last 3 months. I have to thank the Prince who had taken extra care of all the 12 standards. He has really motivated them, he inspired them. Every day and night I used to remember making them all sit over there and, you know, give them the lessons. But really all the students in the last few months, they took it up very seriously and that shows that the results have come out very well. And a big salute to him and his team for the wonderful results they have given in 2014. And we are looking forward to hear and see more and more, not only in academic but in all other extracurricular activities which this George's Laidlaw is known for. Thank you and thank you.
I won't take as long as Jaikumar, but just a short word on the alumni. Most alumni associations around the globe are formed to bring people together, but I think what I want to reiterate once again, and I've been saying this ever since I joined Laidlaw, is this alumni goes beyond just bringing people together. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank this alumni and all the members worldwide for their devotion to the school and for their lifelong commitment to the development of this school. I think this is what makes the Old Georgian Alumni Association different from other alumni. We do have various other schools and colleges with strong alumni bodies, but I think what makes this different is the continuing interest and the lifelong commitment that you, ladies and gentlemen, have towards all the good of this school. And I want to use this platform to thank you on behalf of the pupils and on behalf of the Board of Management for all that you do for the school. And I look forward to sharing this bond and growing closer with each one of you. And as I said, I hope that we continue to grow as one Georgian family, the past, the present and the future, to even greater heights. Thank you so much.
Somebody pass the report.
Receive, consider and adopt the financial statement of the association as on 31-3-2014 along with the report of auditors thereon. To consider the appointment of statutory auditors of the association to hold office from the conclusion of this AGM till the conclusion of the next AGM and to fix the remuneration. Mrs. Mani and Co., Chartered Accountants, who are to command are eligible for reappointment. Can we go ahead with this? Thank you. Now comes the last and the main agenda of the AGM, elections. So we will all get down from here. Okay. MC, a request. Our patron to be the election officer. Elections for the term 2014-16. The patron of the association, Mr. Michael James, will preside over the proceedings with the assistance of the election officer, Georgette D.R. Tamilarasu. The following office bearers and executive members will be elected by the members to serve the association for the period commencing from the conclusion of this annual general meeting till the conclusion of the 27th annual general meeting to be held in 2016. The posts: President, Vice President, Secretary, Joint Secretary, Treasurer, and 10 executive committee members. Pardon.